You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Friday, the 11th of September, 2020, 23rd week in ordinary time. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Dr. Rueza Protus, a Daily Bread member from Ohima, Uganda.
I have become all things to all men, that I might by all means save some. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Corinthians 1, chapter 9, verses 16 up to 19, then 22b up 27. Brethren, if I preach the gospel, that gives me no ground of boasting, for necessity is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel, for if I do this of my own will, I have a reward. But if not of my own will, I am entrusted with a commission. What then is my reward? Just this, that in my preaching I may make the gospel free of charge, not making full use of my right in the gospel. For though I am free from all men, I have made myself a slave to all, that I might win the more. I have become all things to all men, that I might by all means save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, that I may share in its blessings. Do you not know that in a race all the runners compete, but only one receives the prize? So run that you may obtain it. Every athlete exercises self-control in all things. They do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we are imperishable. Well, I do not run aimlessly. I do not box as one beating the air, but I pommel my body and subdue it, lest after preaching to others, I myself should be disqualified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Leonard Kirikarama Akiki, a Daily Bread member from the Diocese of Ohima, Uganda.
Can a blind man lead a blind man? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 6, verse 39 to 42.
At that time, Jesus told his disciples a parable. Can a blind man lead a blind man? Will they not both fall into a pit? A disciple is not above his teacher, but everyone, when he is fully taught, will be like his teacher. Why do you see the speck that is in your brother's eye, but do not notice the log that is in your own eye? Or how can you say to your brother, "Brother, let me take out the speck that is in your eye," when you yourself do not see the log that is in your own eye? "You hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to take out the speck that is in your brother's eye." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Paul now comes back to himself as one of the questions that was raised by the Corinthian community was about his preaching and why he preaches the way he does, that it is boring. Paul wanted to make it clear to the Corinthian community that his preaching ministry was a necessity. It is something that he could not do without. It was something that was coming from within, such that he was impelled, compelled by necessity. And so he says, if I preach the gospel, that gives me no ground for boasting. For necessity is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. It was a necessity for him, and preaching the gospel for Paul was not just something that was done in word. It was done through his own life, the way he lived it. And that's why I love this passage, and that's why that was the passage I chose for my own diaconate, where preaching was already something that was within me and something that I could not do without. And I said, woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. And I'll make use of every opportunity, of every medium, to make sure that the word reaches people. Paul does not just tell us that he has been preaching by his writing or by the way he has been going around. No, his preaching has been in his own life. He has preached through his own life. How did he preach? He says, "For I have made myself a slave to all, that I might win them all." Becoming a slave to all, he became somebody who made others benefit, even if he had nothing to benefit from them. That's what a slave is all about. A slave is one who works, who labors, even without expecting any pay. Because that slave has been sold. Paul had been sold by Christ to give his life for the sake of others. He says, not making full use of my right in the gospel, the right to benefit from the gospel, that I would have eaten from the gospel, because that itself is enough of an employment. I did not do that. This man was a tent maker. This man was a proud man who did not rely on the preaching of the word for his own living, for his own bread. No, he worked. He was a proud man. And yet he says, even if I had that right, I would have been feeding from the gospel. No, I wanted it to be free of charge. And I would give it free of charge, even from my own life. I became all things to all men. Becoming all things to all men was adjusting according to the people he met. He adjusted with the Athenians. He became a philosopher among the Athenians. He became poor among the Thessalonians. He became rich among the Philippians. He was everything to everyone. He mingled with the educated and the non-educated. Why was he doing all that? He wanted the word of God to reach everybody. He wanted everyone to benefit. And this is something we have to learn from Paul, where we don't segregate whom we connect ourselves to, where we don't make the political affiliations prevent the word of God from reaching the people. I become as one who sympathizes with the opposition. I become as one who sympathizes with the ruling party. I become all things to all men. Balanced, siding with no one, but belonging to everyone. So that people may fall in love with Christ. People may fall in love with the word that comes out of my mouth. And this is what is required of everyone who works for God. Don't take sides as a man of God. Don't take sides when you are preaching to people. Everyone belongs to Christ and everyone deserves the message of Christ. If you are to reprimand people, reprimand them. But not because you belong to the other party. No, but because you see this is the right thing to do at this moment. To help them in the brotherly fashion, in the sisterly fashion, to help them be on the true path. Becoming all things to all men is part of preaching. Becoming all things to all people is part of preaching. Paul became that. And he wants to tell the Corinthians to keep running, that we are in a race and you don't just stop where you are. No, you have to start running. Don't stay where you are. You have to run a race of faith. So he says, so run that you may obtain it. Every athlete exercises self-control in all things. He knew there was no self-control among the Corinthians. He knew they were even going to Eros, the god of sex. He knew they were going on that mountain to do terrible things, and he asked them to have self-control. Self-control is part of our journey, running. If you are an athlete, you have to train yourself in self-control. You have to say no to certain things that affect your Christian faith. It is about your faith. It is about your journey. Not any other. You are running to win a race. And running requires going into yourself, introspecting to see what needs to be changed in order for you to run a true race of faith. Jesus tells us what we need to do. Don't focus on other people. Focus on yourself. Remove, first of all, the log that is in your eye. Many of us become superficial in our lives because we focus too much on other people. We poke our nose in other people's affairs. Yes, on Sunday we focused on how we can be watchmen of one another to help each other. But first of all, a blind man cannot lead another blind man. No, first of all, deal with your blindness, that log that is in your eye. You have failed to get rid of your addiction. You have failed to get rid of that unfaithfulness. You have failed to get rid of that habit that is affecting even your prayer life. Get rid of that first before you can help other people. Jesus says, you hypocrite, first take the log out of your own eye and then you will see clearly. To take out the speck that is in your brother's eye. Before you are in a position even to help other people, help yourself. Let the word of God apply to you first before it applies to other people. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me. And I'm desperate for you. And I'm lost without you. This is the air I breathe. This is the air I breathe. Your holy presence, living Your best.